Up next this week is The Crazies, which is a remake of one of George Romero's zombie movies, which I haven't seen. I can tell you that I'm no fan of George Romero. I think he's a hack. And if he were working in any other genre outside of the zombie movie genre, which granted he helped create, you know, nobody would pay him any attention. The bar is way low on zombie movies. But anyway, this one's directed by Breck Eisner, who previously assaulted movie audiences with the movie Sahara. And it's about a small town in Iowa that people start going crazy, as the title suggests. And for unexplained reasons, you know, one guy burns down his house with his wife and son inside. Another guy shows up at a baseball field with a loaded shotgun. And quickly, the town sheriff, played by Timothy Oliphant, gets in over his head. Then the military shows up, and you know they have to basically escape the quarantine zone because they're not infected. Mm-hmm. They don't think. So you know, I mean, zombie movies really. I mean, there's two types. There's the purely genre movies, which don't have anything really to say. It's just there's good guys and there's zombies, and then usually the military. And they just sort of mix it up, and then you get to the end. And then there's the zombie movies like 28 Days Later that have something more interesting to say. They mm-hmm. just use that genre as a vehicle to say it. And this is really the former.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, it's a decent enough genre movie. I would imagine it's better than George Romero's version. But, you know, I mean, it's not...
Only by sheer speculation.
Yeah. Sheer speculation. I haven't seen it, so... That's just my dislike of George Romero talking.
Yeah. I mean, I think the characters did, you know, fairly decent. Timothy Oliphant, I like him. Mm-hmm. Rhoda Mitchell plays his wife, the town doctor. I mean, it's one of those small towns where there's the sheriff and he has a deputy, and the deputy walks around in blue jeans and hiking boots for his uniform. You know, and I think that one of the things that I didn't like about this was that... Most of you know the scares that were in it were not perpetrated by the zombies. I mean, most of the big jumps that were in this were either from the military or a fake scare that just comes out of nowhere type of thing.
Yeah,
you know, I mean, it. You know,
it's probably about half and half.
Yeah, but I mean, it. I think it loses a little bit of something when it's you know, but I mean, and not a lot because of this is you know. A horror movie, and I don't put a lot of you know credence behind the things that happen in them. I mean, other than to be entertained and give you a little bit of a shock, and I mean it did both of those things.
Yeah, and you know where they end up at the end of the movie, it's a little ridiculous. you know, this is a movie that resolves itself by really hinting at you know it's just going to start mm-hmm. over again. And I mean, come on. Finish the movie. Don't just say, oh, well, here we go again.
Yeah.
In a bigger community. I mean, that's a little irritating. And I don't think it's a move to hint at a sequel. It's just
no.
They just don't know what else to do at the end of the movie. So, like, oh, well, it's just going to happen again. But, I mean, you know, if as far as the purely genre movies go, this one is well made.
Oh, yeah. It's competent.
Yeah. And, you know, they've got, you know, the ridiculous government conspiracy thing that started the whole mess. So, and I'll say see it. Based solely on that, I mean, but it's not going to offer anything more than just zombie scares. So, ultimately, see it.
Yep,
and we'll be right back.